In this video, I'll take you through basic settings that you can carry out on an NVR using the automatic startup wizard. This is the first dialog box you meet whenever you successfully boot an NVR. And this is the start of the auto startup wizard. This dialog box presents QR codes that you can scan to download the apps for remote login of your CCTV on your mobile phone or mobile devices. You can check my description box below to access a video I made on remote view of your CCTV on your mobile phone or any mobile device. Let's move on to the next window. The first item here, which is Cloud CID, we will see that under network settings. So I want us to move ahead to language. Under language, you have the chance to choose the language in which you want your NVR menus to appear. So what it means is that when you want to see all these write-ups that you see on the page in your own language, then you just have to look for your language. And then as you activate it, you have all the menus appearing or all the write-ups appearing in your own language for you to have it easy to work with. The date format is the order in which you want your date to appear on your NVR. It could be the year, followed by the month, and then followed by the day, or any other order that you prefer to have your date on your NVR. You'll then go ahead to set the date itself and then the time. Auto synchronized time mode enables your time to be updated through the internet connected to the NVR. So this can only work when you have internet service connected to your NVR. You can as well set your time zone. DST setting, that is daylight savings time. This is applicable to those in the US and other locations where time zone switches at different times of the year. So through this, you can set the NVR to automatically pick a new time zone as it changes. Ticking this setting will make it that anytime you start or restart the NVR, it will show you the auto startup wizard. Let's move on to the next page. On this page, you will be able to create a login account for all those that you want to permit to access your NVR. The essence of this is to restrict access to your NVR so that by this, you will give everyone a username and a password to use in accessing the NVR. There are two types of user groups that you can create. You have the local user, which is those that can physically access your NVR, and network users for those that will be logging onto the NVR by remote view. Basically, each account that you will create requires a username and password, and this is where you create the details as to the username and the password. Let's go on to the next window. On this window are internet settings required for remote access of your NVR. When you choose automatic or DHCP, which is the recommended setting, all the other values will be automatically loaded from your internet access. So you can just click on next. This page gives you the chance to search and add or remove cameras. Your NVR may not have it in the same way as this one, but will be similar to what I have here. For my NVR, and like many other NVRs, you will have to click on search and all connected cameras will get loaded for you. On my NVR, the add enables you to add individual cameras, whilst the add all enables you to add all the cameras at the same time. Advanced add is used in adding cameras that are not of the same brand with the NVR. This particular feature is what is called the OnViv feature. At the bottom here, you can remove individual cameras by using remove, or use remove all to remove all connected cameras. You can customize your NVR, fix IP conflicts, customize camera settings, and so on, all on this page. This page is more of information that is describing the technical qualities of your camera videos in terms of the picture quality, the camera bit rates, and then the frames per second. So we'll just move on to the next page. This page tells about the hard disk drive or the surveillance drive installed in the NVR. This is where you can tell the capacity of your hard disk drive, the space that has been used up, and then also the status of the hard disk drive. You can also format your hard disk drive to make it empty and ready for fresh recordings from this same page. After this, you can just click on finish, and you are done with the basic settings that you can do on your NVR.